Hi, my name is Amir Khan. I'm the 2004 Olympic silver medalist in Athens. I'm here today acting as a boxing trainer for CNN. So let's call the contestants.
Amir, thanks for joining us at the All Stars in London. I'm Aisha, and this is Ben, our sports
producer.
Hi, Ben.
Hi, Amir. Good to meet you.
So what are you going to be showing us today?
Well, the basis of boxing, really, we're going to first of all work on warming up. Then we're going to work on throwing combination, how you throw a punch. And thirdly, we'll work on defense, which will be keeping the guard up and also moving around and using your feet, avoid getting hit. So let's do it.
So why do we start skipping?
You know, skipping's a good way of warming up, just warming the legs up and, I mean, just getting that hand-eye coordination going, getting into that rhythm. I think it's the best way of warming up for any type of training.
It's easy.
Once you've got the rhythm.
Sounds like a blizzard.
It goes easy.
Okay, that's all right.
Try keep bouncing.
Okay.
Spot, yeah. You can get the knee higher.
So how long do we have to skip for?
Till I say stop. And now we warmed up. We work on, you know, throwing the basic punches in boxing. So like the jab, the right hand, the left up, the uppercut. Punch comes from balls of your feet. That's where the power is going to start. That's where the punch is going to start from.
So the punch starts from the feet?
From the feet, yeah. Not from the hand. Because if you're going to punch with your hand without moving your feet, you're not going to get no power in it. But it comes from your feet. Then turning your hips a little bit. And then the punch will come itself. Well, we'll do it for you first. Throw that jab. Extend your arm fully. And then bring it back. And I want the hand to come right back onto towards near the chin. Jab. And step out. Perfect. Now try double jab. That's good. Extend your arm fully. Yeah, that's it. Yep. Nice and loose. Now start bouncing. Get nice and loose. And now throw that right hand and twist with it. Perfect. Jab, jab, right hand. Straight right hand, yeah. Right. Jab, jab, right hand, left up. Jab, jab, back hand, left up. Perfect.
So we've done the jab and the hook.
Yep.
What's the last punch?
The last punch is the uppercut. Jab, right hand, left hook, uppercut. Right, and but go right through with the uppercut, right? That's it, yeah. And what the uppercut does is it lifts your head up and your opponent's head up. When you hit him with that shot, bang, he's going to lift it up and you can finish him off with the hook.
So, Amir, we've learned how to attack. Can you show us, or show Ben, how he can defend himself?
Okay, yeah, the basis of defending is either you just put your guard up and you can defend like that. Now, you want to cover your temple, but you need room to see through your boxing gloves as well. So
when people do that, that's kind of not boxing, really.
No, that's not boxing.
That's Queensbury rules.
That's right, yeah. So them days are gone, you know, that's why they used to get knocked out every round. That's the perfect defender. Now, I can't forget that through the uppercuts. I'm working the body, I can't. Your elbows are protecting your bodies.
Yep.
And you can't throw a jab or right hand or left hook because you're fully defending
can we just yourself. Test
yeah. he's covered himself. So basically, you're not getting hit with none of the punches that we've been working on: the jab, the left hook, the uppercut, the right hand. Mm-hmm. And sometimes you might not want to stand there for too long because it does take a lot out of you when you are taking those shots on your, especially on your shoulders and stuff. So what you might want to do is move away. And say you do get caught on the ropes, then you have to obviously put your guard up.
Well, we were talking about being intimidated earlier, and I was very intimidated when we got into the ring. That was my first time. How was it for you when you stepped into the ring in Athens?
I was very scared at first because I was the only fighter there from Britain. I remember walking in the finals towards the ring, and there must have been about 20,000 people in the arena and millions watching around the world. And I was really nervous, but I was just going through the game plan. You just have to stay focused. You know, it's the biggest tournament in the whole wide world.
What did it feel like when you actually got hold of that Olympic medal?
It meant the world to me because, you know, holding an Olympic medal was something I dreamt of. I mean, my heroes like Muhammad Ali. For me to have an Olympic medal at the age of 17 is the best feeling ever. You know, people ask me what's the biggest achievement. It has to be the Olympic Games, because that's what made me the person I am. Right, enough of the Olympic talk. Let's get you two in the corners and let's see who the better fighter is. Ben, Aisha, touch gloves. I want a good, clean fight. Make sure you defend yourselves at all times as well, eh? Ding, 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 bell's gone. That's a good jab, that. Keep moving, Ben. Good body shot. Some speed there as well, speed and power in that. Shot. And that'll be enough, that. That'll be enough, guys. I'm gonna have to declare Aisha as the champion and the winner, because she showed a lot of heart. She come in there, a lot of good jabs. There were good right hands there, good left hooks, good uppercuts. So she basically covered everything. Well done. But you did a great job, Ben.